Today we are going to start evolution, but before starting with the theories of evolution or about the theories of origin of life and all the other complicated things about the evolution, I would like to discuss some things which we have already known. Origin of universe. It is estimated that, or it is said that, around 20 billion years ago, universe was consisted only of the cosmic material or primeval matter. What is cosmic material and primeval matter? It is red hot, vast, dense cloud of electrons, protons, neutrons, particles, and antiparticles. Of these all things, at about 20 billion years ago, universe was consisted of red hot, vast, dense cloud of electrons, protons, neutrons, particles, and antiparticles. But around 10 to 15 billion years ago, 10 to 15 billion year ago, according to one theory named Big Bang theory, around 10 to 15 billion years ago, there happened a huge nuclear explosion between this concentrated cosmic material and the primeval matter. So, because of that huge nuclear explosion between these primeval matter, all the cosmic materials or all the materials which were present inside that, they were thrown away due to the explosion. Due to the force, they were thrown away, and again they become compacted to form the organized structure like stars and planets. So, by the explosion of the Big Bang theory, some of the materials called cosmic materials, they are also called as nebular material, they were thrown away and they were again organized to form the stars and the planets and the all the other heavenly bodies. So, many of these stars and the planets combine together and form a solar system, and thousands and the lakhs of the solar system combine together and form our Milky Way or our galaxy. Many of the solar system combine together and form the galaxies. Our galaxy is Milky Way, in which we people live, or it is also called as Akash Ganga. And crores and crores of the galaxies combine together and form ultimately the universe. So, around 20 billion years ago, they were consisted only of the primeval matter. And after that, around 10 to 15 billion years ago, what happened is a nuclear explosion, that is also called as Big Bang. Nuclear explosion happened and ultimately the universe was formed. So, the concept of this Big Bang theory was proposed by three scientists. They are abelemmata, gamo and decay. This concept of the Big Bang theory was proposed by these three scientists. Now, let us find out the age of the Big Bang. Age of Big Bang. This is important, the point of view of exam. Now, what we have studied here, the Big Bang happened around 10 to 15 billion years ago. So, we can estimate it as 10 billion years ago. Now, 1 billion equals to 1,000 million and 1 million equals to 10 lakh or 10 to the power 6 we can write it as. So, 10 billion or around 10 billion years ago, we can write it as 10 into 1000 into 10 lakh or 10 to the power 6 equals to 10 into 10 to the power 3 into 10 to the power 6 equals to 10 to the power 10 years. This is the age of our Big Bang. 10 to the power 10 years ago, Big Bang has happened. Now, after the origin of universe, origin of solar system. Solar system has been originated around 4.5 billion years ago, and two scientists named Kant and Laplace. They proposed one theory named nebular hypothesis. What they proposed? A theory named nebular hypothesis to explain the origin of this universe. What they said in their theory that we have already studied here that because of the explosion in the primeval matter, Big Bang happened. And according to Kant and Laplace, according to their nebular hypothesis, they said that universe or the solar system has been originated by the condensation of the part of the primeval matter. So, primeval matter jab condense hoga, uska ek part has been condensed and that formed a solar system. And sun has been condensed in the center and all the other planets and the stars has been thrown away. So, according to the Kant and Laplace, this is how the solar system has been formed. Condensation hua of the part of the primeval matter, then sun has been condensed in the center and all the other stars and the planets have been thrown away. This is how our solar system has been formed. And origin of life. Life has been originated around 4.6 billion years ago. These were the things which we have already known. Now, we will discuss about the conditions which were present at the time of origin of life. What were the conditions at the time of origin of life? First, high temperature. There was very high temperature around 800 to 900 degrees Celsius. And the lighter elements, the lighter elements like methane, ammonia, helium, hydrogen and water vapor. The lighter elements were present in the form of gases, methane, ammonia, helium, hydrogen, water vapor. These lighter elements are always present in the form of gases. Why here water vapor? Because of this high temperature. High temperature होने के कारण water liquid state में नहीं बना रह सकता. That's why that liquid state of water converted into the water vapor. And the heavy elements like iron and nickel, they form the core of the earth. How they form the core of the earth? The earth has been, it is estimated that, ye matlab kaha jata hai, that earth has been formed by the condensation of some of the eddies and all these materials. So, while condensation of all these things, there has been an increase of the temperature. So, jaise jaise temperature badhta jayega, vaise vaise earth ke jo inside material, the inside material of the earth which were present there at that time, they started melting. So, melting start hone se, they started to accumulate in the central part of the earth. So, what were the things that started accumulating? All the heavy metals like iron, nickel, silicon, etc. All these things started accumulating in the central part of the earth. And that central part of the earth is called as core. So, all the heavy materials started accumulating in the central part of the earth and it formed the core part. And energy sources, what were the energy sources at that time? UV and lightning. These were the energy sources for that time. So, here earth's core has been formed by the heavy elements and earth's crust has been formed by the accumulation of the lighter elements. Ye to bana by the melting of the part of the earth, melting of the heavy elements of the earth. So, uske baad mein, jab lighter elements which were present away from the central part of the earth, they also started melting. And when they started melting, they started dragging away from the central part of the earth. So, jaise jaise wo central part of earth se dur hote gaye, they started accumulating here in the surrounding and they started surrounding the earth. So, this part of the earth is called as crust and these are formed by the lighter elements like magnesium, etc. And the part which is present between the core and the crust, it is called as mantle. It is the mantle, middle part of the earth or the mantle. Now, we will discuss about the theories of the origin of life. Theories of origin of life. Many of the scientists gave many theories. बहुत सारे साइंटिस्ट ने अपनी अपनी थियोरीज दी एंड उनके ड्रॉबैक्स भी आए. सम थियोरीज वर एक्सेप्टेड, सम थियोरीज वर डिस्कार्डेड. वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ऑल दीज थियोरीज. फर्स्ट थियोरी ऑफ spatial creation. This theory was given by Father Suarez. This theory was given by Father Suarez, and it is totally based upon the religious concept. It was a religious theory. What it said, that the whole earth or the whole world is made by the supernatural power, that is God. And according to the Christian mythology, they said that the God has created the whole world in 6 days. And the first man is Adam, and first woman is Eve. This was according to the Christian mythology, that the whole world has been created by God in 6 days, and the first man which was created was Adam, and the first woman was Eve. And according to Hindu mythology, what Hindu mythology said, that the whole world or the whole earth is made up of, is made by Lord Brahma. The creator of our earth is Lord Brahma, and the first man he created is Manu, and first woman he created is Shraddha. What according to Hindu mythology, that Lord Brahma has created this whole world, and first man what he is created is Manu, and first woman is Shraddha. So this theory was totally based upon the religious concept. So there was no proof of this theory, that from where this men and women has been created, and actually who has created this the whole world. So this theory was discarded by many scientists. Next, theory of abiogenesis. What this theory said, that this theory actually was given by von Helmont. And according to von Helmont, life is created by non-living things. What he said, that life has been originated continuously from the non-living things in the spontaneous manner. Therefore, this theory of the abiogenesis is also called as theory of spontaneity. Theory of abiogenesis was proposed by von Helmont. He said that the life has been originated from non-living matters in a repeated form and in the spontaneous manner. Therefore, this theory is also called as theory of spontaneity. And this theory, many of the scientists and a couple of the scientists gave many examples in the favor of this abiogenesis theory. What they said, that a hair of white horse, when dipped in the water, hair of white horse, when dipped into the water, it will grow into the hair larva of horse, which is called as gordius. What they said, when a hair from the tail of the white horse is being dipped into the water, it will turn into the hair larva of the horse, which is called as gordius. And von Helmont personally did an experiment. What he said, that when he kept his sweat soaked shirt, he kept his sweat soaked shirt along with wheat grains, and due to the fumes of this sweat soaked shirt when mixed with the wheat grains, it gives rise to the mice population. So how it is possible? And one more example, that mud of the river Nile, when exposed to the sunlight, it will give rise to many organisms like fishes, amphibians, etc. These were the three examples which were given by many scientists. First, that hair of the white horse, when dipped into the water, it will turn into a larva. And second, which was done by personally by von Helmont, that when he kept his sweat soaked shirt along with the wheat grains, then it will give rise to the population of mice. And the mud of the river Nile, when exposed to the sunlight, then it will give rise to variety of the organisms like fishes, amphibians, reptiles, etc. So this theory was discarded by Francisco Redi,